commoner boy was able to prove himself to the president and the first lady, all thanks to the etiquette lessons provided by the butler. But we don't know how to end it.
Come on, guys, you know how this goes. Now he wins the heart of their daughter.
But he's never even met her.
Believe it or not, that doesn't actually matter. People don't want to know why the characters fall in love. They just want a happy ending. A happy ending of true love.
Oh. Nicholas, how'd you get to be such a great writer?
Well, when I first joined Conventional Plays United, I was writing stories about sad characters with real-life problems, sometimes without a happy ending or a big kiss at the end. I had no clue what I was doing. And then I learned the correct way to write. And now Conventional Plays United is one of the most successful playwriting companies in New York City.
But what makes our company so much better than everyone else's?
Well, unlike the other companies, we know how to follow the formula. There's a way that this can happen, a way that we can grow, and as long as we all follow it, it works. With the formula that guarantees a hit, situations need to cycle, and we leave all their quirks. But the stories that we write are too original, and though the characters are not exactly new, it needs originality. The truth is in reality, the basics, well, it's just there's a formulaic formula, so easy not to fail.
There's
a formulaic formula.
It has writers who experiment with hypotheses.
Now there's a formulaic formula.
That's why I try to play an album.
We have instructions that were made for us. Don't think about it, don't ask why. Broadway used to be a place where your wildest dreams can happen. But now success is guaranteed, so you don't even have to try with that formula.
No. Hold on, everyone. This isn't right at all, so don't please tell me what this is. And as the brave knight slowly lowers his shield, the princess timidly responds, "I'm sorry, but no, I won't marry you." No? Why would she say no to being happy for the rest of her life?
Come on, Mr. Wilkowski, it's the same thing we always do. But this time the ending is realistic.
You know what happened if we put this on Broadway? People don't want realistic endings. They want happy endings. Mr. Grimwell, as in the CEO of Conventional Plays United, has come up with the perfect story writing formula that will have audiences coming back every single time, and you want to change that? That just doesn't make sense.
What if they like it more?
Let me rent another good show. But if they don't like it, they don't come to our shows anymore. And soon, the company will stop making money, and then we will lose our jobs, and then the painful reality of life without a job would set in, leaving all of us poor, homeless, starving, on the streets, and likely deprived of life's most basic human rights like happiness and love!
Why?
You don't think,
Nicholas, all I do is think. There's a way things have to happen if we want to keep our job. Doing otherwise just isn't worth it. Then we could actually die! So use that formulaic formula! Don't try to be creative, just figure out why. Yes, our dreams are all important, that I understand. We've got writers who could really make it big. But I don't want to be harmless, none of you want to be homeless. So just shut those things way down.
Thank you.
Father. Everyone gather around.
Every day, we have to do this.
Hello?
Honey, darling, here's one and only love of all my life. I look forward to our phone calls every day. I saw you 30 minutes earlier, but it feels like it's been weeks.
Honey, darling, there is the way I feel the same. Now I'll let the kids say hello to their father. Hello, Daddy, that's the usual report. I'll be myself, I'll have fun, I'll do everything bad. I'm in class and fight with teachers just to sport. As for me, well, there's no reason why I ever would complain, because statistically I live a perfect life. I get fulfillment when I cook and clean and love my kids and husband. It's the dream of every 1950s wife. That's crazy just to think that this is happy.
What do you mean?
They seem miserable, but somehow that's ideal.
Well, that's just because adults are different.
Look, I really need to get going right now. It's just, you see, I kind of have some stuff to do today, and honestly, I probably should be here right now. And it, you know, it was really nice meeting you, Summer. It's just that it's time for lunch. Let's break, everyone! Oh, boy!
All right, thank you, the last one. Who wants to drive Grandma to the Waffle
House? You want a lunch, buddy? Doesn't have to be Waffle House. Anywhere you want to go is fine with me. Unless you don't eat lunch anymore. As a part of your new diet that only allows the consumption of breakfast foods, not me, whenever you feel comfortable.
Where the hell have you been? Did you even go to college, or is that just some way to get out of the house again?
It's not like that!
Then explain it to me.
Home wasn't exactly full of fond memories for me. I needed to distance myself. Just might have overdone it.
Yeah, maybe a little.
I'm sorry. I've been going through some bad shit.
Well, you know, I don't know what you expect from me. 15 years of no contact, and what, I just drop everything and help you?
I'm not asking you to help me.
Then what are you trying to do?
Reconnect with my brother. Fix something that's broken. It might not be something that I deserve, but we're family. And when there's no one else to turn to, I figured if anybody is going to forgive me, it's Nikki.
You could have called once.
Yeah. Hey, it's me. I know that things have been a little weird since I left home without really saying goodbye, but if you're free this weekend, I would love to meet your family and catch up on the last half of our lives.
Yeah, that was it.
Right.
What are you doing here?
I know it's random, but I miss you. And if you're not doing anything this weekend, I would love to meet your family and catch up on the last half of our lives.
And where will you be staying while we do that?
With my wonderful brother who
wow,
loves me.
Okay, yeah.
For maximum twin bonding time, it's the only way.
I guess we could find a spare mattress somewhere. Okay. It's, Nicholas, actually.
Gross. So, what's the plan, Nickelback?
Well, I have work until 5, and then I think Danielle is making dinner.
Whoa,
so probably...
wait. We're in New York City. You have to show me around.
Summer, I have work.
Just say there's a family emergency.
What emergency?
Your sister was dying
oh
of
God.
Hunger,
really?
So you had to take her to all the pizza places in the city.
Summer, I don't know. I really
and
should.
You were dying from a lack of doing good shit with your sister.
Oh, yeah, good one, yeah.
It was a serious medical emergency. They rushed you to the nearest shopping outlets and to all the nearest hot dog stands. It was almost too late until they finally
okay, fine, fine, fine. We'll go.
Hell yeah. Let's go! That is not the Nicholas Brightsman I know.
I'm sorry, that's completely on me.
It's okay. Next time, tell me.
Of course. Also, I told Summer that...
Thank you.
is wrong with that?
We've heard stories like that a million times.
It's mundane and overused. How about something fresh?
Okay, fresh. There once was a brave little peasant. A hero was there. A prince. What do you guys want?
Choice.
to know.
What's wrong? What's wrong?
I cannot figure out how to fix this flying metaphor.
The flying metaphor?
I mean, it's just so on the nose, like what it represents, learning to fly, representing freedom. I mean,
Imagination land?
I mean, the dragon probably just chased after them anyway, which kind of ruins the whole point of the metaphor.
Sweetheart, why are you writing? You never bring work home with you.
Oh, honey, this isn't work. I was just telling the kids a story, and I wanted to write it down for fun.
Well, couldn't you write for fun tomorrow at the office?
Yeah, sure.
Awesome. Let's get some sleep.
Good night. Unless it's the dragon that teaches them how to fly.
I know,
it sounds ridiculous, but keep in mind it is a child's imagination. Plus, this could be a way of saying that people can overcome their obstacles instead of just avoiding them.
Nicholas, I love you, sweetheart, I do, but don't you feel like you might be wasting your time?
What do you mean?
Well, these aren't the stories you usually write. I don't want you to get your hopes up
and then what?
And then get let down. I mean, what if the boss doesn't like it?
He might like it.
But you don't know that. Besides, this is all just for work anyways, right?
Yeah, of course. I'm sorry, I just got carried away.
No, it's okay. You just got excited, but for now,
searching for employment, not knowing when he's gonna get food next. Oh my God, I can't
I hear your coffee is better than half of Manhattan's. I'm eager to try it.
How do you take it?
Lots of cream, lots of sugar, thank you. Of course I do. You guys are what make this company, well, what it is. Bean counters like me only have beans to count because of you. And I'm convinced that our staff in particular is among the most talented in New York City.
Here you go, sir. Lots of cream, lots of sugar, just like you asked.
Thank you very much. And please, call me Charles. May I call you Clarence?
Oh, you can call me by your name. I mean, you can call me Clarence. Yeah.
Are true, Clarence. This is fantastic.
thank you, sir. I mean Charles. So, what's brought you to our neck of the woods? You know, sure, the Rockstar of Broadway has a lot more things to do than just come over.
Oh, Clarence, don't sell yourself short. This is what Broadway's all about, right? Phantom is Phantom because of Andrew Lloyd Webber and Richard Stilgo, not some executive.
You damn right, sir. That's very kind of you, sir. Charles!
You can call me whatever you want, Clarence, and it should be kind, seeing as I'm asking for your help.
My help?
Well, your whole team, actually. I think I've got our next big project. I haven't felt this good about a show in a long time.
That's wonderful, sir, wonderful. Whose show?
Mine, actually. Well, the treatment, anyway.
Oh my God, I had no idea. I can't wait to hear it.
That's the idea. I'd like to pitch it to your office today, if you have time.
Oh, of course we have time. We have time right now. Everybody go to the conference room. Someone got a whiteboard. Mr. Grimwald's pitching up this big idea.
I particularly like to hear your thoughts. Starting today, Conventional Players United will take its place at the head as the premier production company on all of Broadway, nay, the entire United States of America. It is here and now that we will put forth the biggest, the best, the most prolific show to ever touch a stage.
from afar, voices from across the stars. His family so far out of range that no one will think it's bizarre.
Mr. Weitzman, I think this play is missing something. And I feel like you agree with me. To be honest, I would order you to. It doesn't seem right.
Yeah, it is missing something.
And what would that be?
I don't know. Isn't it the same play we always do? I mean, it's definitely louder.
You're saying there's not enough substance.
I think that we have a chance to do something different for once. We don't have to rely on the same things we always know people like. I mean, we're a financially stable company, and let's be real, whatever we put out, people will come and see. So, maybe take some risks. Worst case scenario, we lose some fans, maybe a little money, but maybe we could say
really help me dissect this thing, split it open, and give it a brain. I'll pay you extra for your time, of course, seeing as how valuable your work is. What do you say?
I'd be an idiot if you
took the words right out of my mouth. Hey, trust your gut, man. Speak up. The only way something bad is going to get better. I'll see you out there, partner.
Knock, knock.
Hey, what are you doing here, Summer?
I just thought that I could bring my... One day I would love to sit in on one of these meetings.
Holy shit, Summer, you have no idea.
What happened?
You were right about everything. The way I was writing, it wasn't me, it wasn't creative, it wasn't different. I think I'm finally ready to start writing for myself.
Wow! So you quit?
No, I didn't quit.
Right, yeah, that's good. So what changed?
Okay, so Mr. Grimwald just came in and asked me to help write his show.
His show?
The most prolific show to ever touch the stage. A show that says a little more than, hey, give us your money. Yeah, it's a work in progress.
So you know what you're doing.
Well, I mean, I don't know if I've worked on
it. I mean, with Grimwald.
What about him?
Charles Grimwald, CEO of Conventional Plays United, rock star of Broadway.
Summer, I know who he is.
All I'm saying is, just remember that you can think for yourself.
I do think for myself. I'm the one who told Mr. Grimwald we shouldn't be doing it just for the money.
And he agreed with you.
Completely.
Hey, I'm sorry. It's just that I've seen you in denial before, and I need to make sure that you are okay.
Summer, I wasn't writing for myself.
I'm not talking about your writing.
Then what?
You left this at home. But I would bring it by before Danielle saw.
Thanks.
Nikki, are you happy? Look, I have mandated a lot of couples therapy before, and it is really
should
not-
I know? If I'm not happy, should there be a reason? Something inherently wrong?
Every marriage is complicated.
I don't care what's complicated, though. There's nothing wrong. There's nothing bad happening to me.
That's all you think it takes?
Shouldn't it be? There's a room full of people out there who would kill to be in my shoes. But no, that's not enough for me. I need to have my life be perfect in every conceivable way so I can be happy. I mean, it's not enough that I'm writing for the rock star of Broadway. No, I still have to have a perfect marriage and the perfect wife who actually talks to me like a real person, or can read and understand me, or support me, wants me to follow my dreams, or shows any interest in me at all.
Why is that selfish? Why is it bad to know what you want?
What kind of person would I be? Person can't decide that they won't empathize with others, that they don't have to see the way their actions stick, the way they hurt, unless that curse is only mine. Is it my burden that I choose what I will do and know how everything plays out ahead of time? Where I'm leaving others in the dirt.
But that's not fair. It's not your job to be the saint. No one else expects you to be miserable without complaint. So get some self-respect and understand you're only human through and through. You have to know that there is only just so far that you go.
Look, if you don't get it.
That we don't have control.
It's not worth it to read.
ideas for journal scripts.
I'm sorry, Miss Winkowski, but I have way too much on my mind right now.
I was thinking that if you're going to be writing with Mr. Grimwell, you might want some advice from a pro.
Mr. Grimwell believes in me. He wants me, and he loves my ideas and my fresh new ideas. And so no offense, Miss Winkowski, but I'll pass on the advice. Cause I'm finally in control.
Sorry about that. You're a little afraid.
You're the one who caused this.
I didn't.
Oh, everything was so much better before you came. We followed the formula and things made sense and nobody died and it was great and then you showed up and now there's this.
I didn't mean to.
Well, you did.
hard. Ted Crazy, I love you.
Thank you, Belmont. You read my mind.
You and I never had a plan. Unstoppable, never will ascend. The total pool of Broadway.
What a perfect life.
But there's one final thing. May I ask with this ring that I share all this joy with my wife?
Yes, of course, Ted.
Your mind and your class to help me improve.
on the other side of town.
Yes.
With your suitcase.
Yes.
I see. So, how long do you think you'll be gone on this walk?
Well,
I'm just saying, you might not want to be gone very long. My father might worry about you.
He's fine. He has a new job and a new life, and clearly he is more happy, so I'm not worried about him. He can take care of himself.
Well, you're out on your walk.
Yeah, I'm just saying that he is an adult.
True, but he's a newly divorced adult. Oh, I'm sure if she hadn't told me, the excessive drinking and crying would have given it away.
I didn't know your mom drank.
It's a fairly new hobby.
I'm really sorry.
You say that like it's your fault.
Your mom seems to think it is.
Do you think it is?
You ask a lot of questions.
Curiosity is the lust of the mind. Thomas Hobbes.
That means that I help married couples or couples who are just dating who aren't getting along as well as they used to.
Like my parents?
Usually the couple is still together when I help them, but yes. I was good at it. I mean, really good at it. I could get one hopeless case after the other, and after only a few sessions, they would already be friendly with each other. I have this way of relating to people, I guess. I think most therapists help their clients from an outside perspective, but for me, it always felt like an inside job, like I was directly involved. Does that make sense? Anyway, one day I get this couple, and it's bad. Every day somebody takes too long in the shower or chews with his mouth open. They just would not listen to me, to each other. It was not getting better. So I started to schedule them for two times a week. They couldn't afford three times a week, so I started to give them additional sessions for free. Everybody said that I should drop them, that having them as my clients was starting to affect me, but I couldn't. I mean, how could I? It felt like I was failing them, and I was not okay with that. More sessions, and at this rate, I'm starting to wonder if it's just some sick fever dream, and then one day they don't show up. They decided it would just be better to get a divorce.
But that's not your fault.
I know. It would be different if I just needed to try harder next time, but I really think that I put everything that I had into fixing their marriage and it didn't help. I should have known. I should have told them that I had to stop seeing them, but I couldn't. What if I were to try and help somebody who didn't stop the sessions?
But at the same time, what if someone needed your help? But out of fear, you didn't offer them the appointment to begin with.
What am I supposed to prioritize? Making other people feel better or my own sanity?
Well, it sounds like you do therapy because it makes you feel good. It's something you like to do, so maybe you can kind of do both.
you getting all this?
Oh, every word, sir. Anyways, we gotta figure out why. I mean, he has a family, right? It could be anything from... what year does this take place in again?
What do you think would work?
Well, I think that whole 18th and 19th century thing, Les Mis has that, you know? And I think the whole medieval fairy tale setting is kind of outdated.
No doubt.
So maybe early 20th century, maybe the Great Depression?
Ooh, that's interesting. Write that down, Clarence.
Already on it. Here's an idea. Does the main character have to be a man?
I prefer to keep it that way.
Why?
You have to understand, Nicholas. We make a play about a girl and it becomes a play about feminism, about the discourse of gender and the female icons, yada, yada, yada. That's all it'll be seen as. We're trying to please a much wider audience.
With all due respect, sir, is that a bit sexist?
Oh, believe me, I have no problems with the female lead, but that's just how people are going to take it. We're at the mercy of society's bigotry, of the market's bias against feminism. I wish it were different as much as anybody.
Okay, all right, so it's a man, a boy in this case, eating dinner with his family, and then one day the police show up and tell Steve's father that the whole family's being evicted.
Evicted? For what?
Because they hadn't paid rent in several months, and now they've been kicked out.
Well, that's just police doing their jobs, isn't it? That wouldn't make them bad guys, per se.
Well, they can still be rude and mean people, but think about how much dimension this would add to the obstacles that the characters face.
And to you or someone like me, that makes sense. But think about how much that would confuse people. We need villains that they can hate, not understand. Just go ahead and cut that part out, Clarence.
I literally couldn't agree with you more, sir. Okay, I guess the police just had it out for Steve's father.
And why? Why did they have it out for him?
Because he used to be a police officer, but quit the force and realized how corrupt the whole system was.
Brilliant. Absolutely inspired.
And when they told Steve's father that he has to leave, they start beating him right in front of his whole family.
Oh, the humanity. Clarence, write that down.
Oh, you couldn't stop me if you tried. Just a young boy can't bear to see his father so humiliated, so animalized. In a moment of pure adrenaline, he takes the gun from the cop's belt and shoots both of the officers.
Well, shoots them? No. Steve is the hero.
Right, but think about how much dimension this would add to his character, showing how far he's willing to go to protect his family.
No. My hero does not kill people. That's far too confusing. But the audience won't know whether they can trust him. Just cut that part out, Clarence.
I don't even know why I bothered writing it, sir. Mr. Grimwald, I appreciate all of this, but this isn't exactly what I pictured when I signed on to work.
Of course not. It really never is. Imagine it a little secret. This, what we're doing, is the curse of the writer. Creative, non-conventional ideas are great, really. But if we fail to communicate as artists to our audience, if they fail to understand what we're trying to say, then how did we fail?
Yeah, I guess. I just don't feel really creative and stuff. You know,
of course not. No one does. It's a burden to bear, and it's a burden not many people can take on, yet still create under such responsibility.
Yeah, I guess.
Anyway. Why don't you take a nice break, go into that coffee room, get yourself some nice espresso or something like that, and when you come back in, I want you to bring some more of those ideas. You're really shaping this into something special. I can't wait to hear the rest of your thoughts.
You will not be disappointed, sir. I will be back in 5 minutes with a pitch that will blow your brains out.
I know you will.
Excuse me. Can I ask you a question?
Well, it's free country, isn't it?
Yeah, that it is. It's free country. Well, you know, see, I'm just a little confused.
And what about?
Well, it's not like Nicholas is a bad writer. No, not what I'm saying. Not at all. He's great. It's just, you know, I'm wondering why I've never worked with you on a project. You see, I've been here for a long time. I've worked on a lot of shows, and I've done everything right.
Clarence. The answer's in the question. Notice how I still have to guide Nicholas with his writing. He's a very bright man, but I don't have the kind of trust in him that I have in someone like you. Now, with you, I could leave you alone for weeks and know that when I came back, you'd have a grade A show to pop on stage. But with Nicholas, I don't know.
Wow, really?
What, did you think I was giving Nicholas some kind of special treatment?
No!
Wasn't that fun?
Outstanding. Say, are you happy to make any more of that coffee I love so much?
You know, funny you should ask. I made a pot just before we got started.
Outstanding. Well, I'm going to treat myself to a cup, and when I get back, we'll get right back to work.
I will be right here.
Clarence, I gotta ask. Don't you get sore?
What do you mean?
Well, Rumbo's always on the move. He's never in one place for too long. So I can't imagine it's mighty comfortable to have your tongue so far up his anus.
Shut up! Did you hear what he said to me?
I sure did, and trust me, I haven't heard flirting like that since my vacation in East Berlin.
Agatha, he likes my writing. He respects me.
Does he respect you? Or does he use you?
All right, enough, Agatha. I've heard enough of this. Why don't you just go back to storage and drink?
You're gonna make me say it, aren't you?
I'm just really busy right now. I don't need to hear you and your negativity. Always
I mean care about your well-being. I don't want to keep seeing you being the Lemming of Broadway. You're better than that. You're more talented than that. And in some ways, I thought of you as just something I couldn't have.
Really?
Well, no. If you were more attractive, you could probably have to have like a boyfriend or a girlfriend or a cat or something like that. Anyways, I found this at the door with your name on it, said to give it to you.
Thanks.
Say hi to Grimmel's left ass cheek for me.
Imagination Land? Go home early, I get my job done, everyone wins.
We play in the kitchen?
You got it.
You're fine with me.
Oh, if you're gonna be up late, Mr. Wilkowski usually leaves some coffee for us in the back. Help yourself.
Thanks, guys. Yeah, I will. Good luck.
Mr. Wilkowski let me in. He said you were working.
How'd you know I'd be here?
Yes. There aren't many places you can go.
I could have gone to a hotel.
You hate hotels. On our honeymoon, every time the lights flickered, you'd freak out.
I wanted to make sure we weren't losing power.
You made me go into the hallway to see if there were twins outside.
I wanted to make sure. I mean, you did it every time.
Every time.
Even though we have to keep pausing that movie.
Why are you doing this?
Danielle, it's not something I
How could you look at me, remember everything we've been through, and then just want to throw it away?
It's more complicated than that.
Then explain it to me, because I don't know what I could have done better.
That's the point. It's not anything you could have done better. We as people just don't mix. Not like we used to.
I think I don't know that. I know how different things are now. I know we should have more of a conversation than just, hi, how was work? Here's your dinner. Good night. I know you've probably had your foot out the door this entire time.
That's not true.
I'm trying my best. I've tried so hard to make our home a happy place, to be the wife who never argues, to make sure that everything is under control.
Oh, why do that? Why live this fake life where we just pretend everything's okay?
Because I don't want to lose you. Because clearly, the second we go out of routine, you start wishing things were different. Summer comes into our home, and then she's doing everything.
Don't put this on Summer. This has nothing to do with her. This is you and me.
Then why do I feel like it's just me? Why am I the only one that seems to remember? Back in high school, sitting on the couch, watching the rain.
You ran outside barefoot. Made me go with you too. Our favorite memories will get caught up in the fights and the arguments and anything negative. I don't want that, Danielle.
Well, by all means, don't let me stand in the way of what you want.
Thank you.
And how are you liking it? The writing, the thriller?
It's different than what I expected, obviously.
How so?
I mean, it's not bad. It's just, sometimes I feel like Mr. Grimmel really knows what people want.
He does.
Yeah, and I mean, I'm sure you understand, it's, sometimes he knows what people want to hear. Not that that's bad or anything, it's just, he's a people person. It's just interesting.
Yeah, above all else, I can confirm that Grimmel's interesting.
I wouldn't necessarily mind if you'd use a few more of my ideas.
Oh my god, you're preaching to the choir.
But I get it, though. It's a business, right? We have to succeed.
Right.
By the way, what's that you've been reading?
Oh, it's just a script that someone left for me. It's really something.
Good word.
Yeah, listen to this. Because what good is trying to understand the universe if we're all at its mercy? Should we strain ourselves by learning all we can only to find out that control is an imaginary concept? Or do we sit back helpless, letting time decide where we go and what we do?
Where did you get that?
I told you, someone just left it for me. Isn't it great?
It's mine.
You wrote this.
Yeah, I mean, I didn't leave it for you, but yeah, I stayed up all night working on that. I mean, what's wrong? Are you okay?
I tried telling him that, sir! I tried!
telling them that we have important work to do.
Oh my God, sir! That's such a good idea!
Yeah.
I can't believe that I never thought of it! You know what? I'm gonna do that right now. This is really embarrassing, and I don't say this a lot, but I forgot where maintenance is.
Never mind, Clarence. Apparently I have to do everything myself. Nicholas, try and keep everyone focused.
Of course, sir.
Writing in pencil.
Care to explain?
La peste de perro guachata! Interminite!
All right. We have already lost plenty of time sitting here, not working.
Mr. Grimmel, can I talk with you alone for a minute?
Of course. I'm sorry, but would you mind stepping out for a minute? What's this all about? I thought we understood each other. And I'm not a man who likes to repeat himself. This is larger than either of us. There are too many wheels turning to just shut this whole machine down.
With all due respect, sir, it's your machine. You can start and stop it whenever you want.
That may be. But apparently I'm the only one here who sees the absurdity of such a thing. So what, I should call every producer, every single
Just stop. I'm not asking you. I'm telling you, I don't want to work on this project. And if you actually respected me, you'd accept that.
Now, hold on. If I respected you, I provided you the platform to showcase your writing on some of the most prestigious stages.
You're right. It's your platform. You gave it to me. But that's the problem. It's not my work anymore. I don't need a censor or a translator like I'm some alien whose words and thoughts are foreign to people. I mean, you understand that, right?
My platform is the only thing that allows people like you to make something of yourselves. I give you this gift, and you criticize me for what? My generosity?
If you're so generous, then why not let me write freely? This is more than just money.
This is a business first. Of course it's about making money. I shouldn't have to explain that to you.
What I'm saying is what we do shouldn't be a business. It can't just be a business.
Clarence, you've been awfully quiet. So tell me, is this true? My greedy liar was nothing good whatsoever to do or say to my staff? Now this is what I suggest. Why don't we forget this little conversation that ever happened, take a nice long break for dinner, and then get back to work. We've lost more than
He's right, sir.
Excuse me?
This is the show we should be doing. Sir Nicholas wrote it himself, without any of your parameters, and it's far better than anything we put out in a long time.
And leave it on my desk.
I'm sorry, sir. But I don't think that's fair to Nicholas.
As long as these ideas are happening on my payroll, I'll decide what's fair, Clarence.
You know what? We don't have to do my show. I wouldn't want you touching it anyway. But I'm sure as hell not doing your show.
You watch your mouth, Brexman. What I do, the way I run things, is what keeps the lights on. It will put food on your tables, on your family's tables. This is utterly absurd.
Look, Mr. Grimmel, you act like if we don't work on this project, the company won't make any money.
If you don't work on this project, you don't work with my company.
So we'll work elsewhere.
There is no elsewhere. I could pick up that phone and have you both on every blacklist in New York, in the entire country.
I'd rather be flipping burgers the rest of my life than filling people's heads with garbage like your show.
If one more insult slithers out of your mouth,
what? You'll fire me? Go ahead. I'll make my way. And if I don't, at least I can sleep at night knowing I tried. Better than being a sellout.
I'm sure to sleep very well on the side of the street. Mr. Wilkowski, what about you? I can't be the only one here with any common sense. You're better than this, turning down success when it's handed to you on a silver platter.
Well, sir, I guess my definition of success is just different than yours.
You know what? This is a waste of my time. I was here long before either of you, and I'll be here long after, too. Enjoy your artistic freedom. It'll be all you have. And when you realize how harsh the world can be, give me a call. Maybe I can find you a job down in Custodial. Though, why should I bother? Such a prestigious position might be too difficult for either of you to hold down.
think writing's for me. You know, I think it would be best if I took some time to myself, you know? Figured out what I'm really passionate about. Learn who Clarence Wilkowski is.
That's awesome.
Hey, if there's one thing that, you know, Mr. Grimmel did get right, we make a pretty good cup of coffee. Maybe start there. Huh. I'm gonna get back to you on that one. I look forward to it.
Way that this
Arbella Mondes. Once again, the rock star of Broadway proves that he knows exactly what people want to see.
Instructions are subjective. If you keep that in perspective, you might find control is something you can't be.
Clarence Mikowski, former manager at Conventional Plays United, opens his new business, a small cafe he calls Bitter Endings.
Not to know what's gonna happen.
Danielle Breslin starts a new business with her former sister-in-law, Summer Breslin.